44th Halloween for 44 days, he gets to eat.
Eat what? Eat what?
Eat us. It's Brittany, and welcome back to Brittyween 2020. Now, today's video, I'm super excited about this. I don't even know where to begin. So, you guys know, like, the paranormal games I live for. I have an absolute blast playing these paranormal games, rituals. I have a whole playlist. I would say my ultimate favorite, number one paranormal game is the elevator game. And I think I actually know, okay. The elevator game is number one, but I think I've played Bloody Mary and Baby Blue probably the most. And that's like including off camera as well. But I've played Bloody Mary so many times on my channel throughout the years. Like, it's crazy. Now, I've also played the elevator game numerous times on my channel. The very first time I ever played the elevator game ever was in Las Vegas at the Paris. So check that out if you haven't seen it yet. I think the second time was Washington, D.C. Check that out. The third time was Toronto, Ontario. Check that out. But what if I told you that, you know, you could be playing the elevator game and you could be experiencing all the stuff going on, like you see the woman on the fifth floor, it takes you to another dimension, and you were trapped in this dimension forever, for eternity. But what if I told you that if nothing really happened as you were playing the game, but there's stuff that could happen to you and that has happened to other elevator game players after they've played the game, and it's stuff that has stuck with them for so long. So, if you are thinking about playing the elevator by yourself, you might want to think again. Now, I don't really give warnings out like this because I live for this and this is what I love doing, but I know there's a lot of people who are like, whoa, girl, like, what the heck is wrong with you? Like, why do you just like walk into the elevator like there's nothing could go wrong? It's because I want something to happen. I don't want something to go wrong, but I want to see the woman. I think that's one of the scariest parts about the game is when you're going to the fifth floor, you're just waiting for the doors to open. And apparently, like, a woman is supposed to come on the elevator. You cannot make eye contact with her. You can't even look at her because she's not what she seems. She's not what she appears to be. She's not an actual woman. She is something that you don't want to mess with. So I think that is in each of my rounds. If you guys have checked out those videos before, you've seen the fear in my face. Like, yes, I do get creeped out. It's just the suspense that builds up, and you don't know if the door's gonna open. You have no idea if you're gonna see that woman standing there, and then she's gonna come on the elevator and you can't look at her. But the thing is, she's probably looking at you. Oh my God, I didn't even say who I am. I am Derry from Jeepers Creepers today, like the female version. I'm kind of like a mixture of Trish and Derry with the hair and then the Bannon shirt. But anyways, let's get into these creepy experiences that people have had after playing the elevator game. So with this game, the whole point is you're going to another dimension and you're gonna be walking around this other dimension, and you could be trapped there forever. Now, some players that have played this game, they have reoccurring dreams of this dimension. They've already been there, but they make their way back. So there is one player that accidentally looked right at the woman when she got on the elevator at the fifth floor. After returning home and going to sleep, the player began having reoccurring dreams of being back in the elevator. She had a dream each night of being in the other world, able to use the elevator the first night, but she could only use the stairs every night afterward. She fears being trapped there. There is another elevator game player that says they made it home that night, but they woke up the next day on the 10th floor of where they were playing the elevator game. One player claimed the woman who entered the elevator on the fifth floor followed him home and banged on his windows at night, laughing at him. Another player dreamed they were back in the other dimension every night and noticed the woman watching them while they went out during the day. Many have felt a presence behind them, following them long after finishing the game. Another player thought the ritual had failed until bloody footsteps showed something had followed him out of the elevator. There's a player named Alex who reportedly saw the woman get on the elevator with him at the fourth floor, but he accidentally looked at her before stumbling out of the elevator at the 10th floor. He saw numerous crosses, all with people being crucified and burned on them. When the elevator returned to take him home, it was full of burned corpses. Another player only saw the woman's feet and dress, but after arriving at the 10th floor, he saw body parts. You know what this kind of reminds me of? You know, the day after, or the week after, or the month after playing the game, it kind of reminds me of Darumasan Fell Down, the bath game. How you start experiencing stuff right after playing. I also played the bath game so many times on my channel. So definitely check that out as well. The elevator game can also make you go insane. Absolutely crazy. Maybe that's why I'm crazy. Maybe the elevator is the cause behind it. Several players have reported hearing strange sounds, having visions, and experiencing extreme paranoia after completing the game. One player believed the woman had followed him home, so he posted on Reddit pleading for help, revealing he had even purchased a gun. Others live in a state of paranoia, afraid they haven't really made it back home. One person saw the face of the woman everywhere she went and whenever she slept. So, what are your thoughts now on trying the elevator game? I mean, I'm still gonna do it. I love that game so much. It's literally like my favorite game. But have I experienced any visions or seeing corpses, you know, body parts, the woman? No. I've had some messed up dreams, but I don't think it has anything to do with the elevator game. I haven't had any weird visions or hearing strange sounds or, you know, even strange scents. I haven't had anything like that. I think the scariest part, if this is all real, you know, these experiences that people are claiming to have after playing the elevator game, is feeling like you don't want to be trapped. You don't want to be trapped in this dimension. And I get that. That freaks me out. I think that's one of the things that actually does scare me, is you don't want to be trapped in another world. You don't want to feel like you could go into this dimension at any time and never return home. You know what I mean? I think that's kind of a stretch, but that is, it sounds like a movie, but that's really creepy. And I think all the experiences that could happen after playing the elevator game are definitely, you know, a good warning and something to think about if you are really freaked out by playing it. But I think if you're really freaked out by playing any of these rituals or any of these games, then you shouldn't. It's really up to you how you feel. I mean, clearly, obviously, nobody's forcing you to try these things. So let me know down below if you have ever played the elevator game, if you are thinking about playing it, or if you know of anybody who has played it and has had a very bizarre experience afterwards or even during the game. Let me know, because I'd love to hear all about that. Obviously. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video. As always, you rock my world, and the song lyrics, Michael Jackson. Hashtag team Britney44, hashtag Baritha runs, hey. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.